Hello everyone, my name is Michelle Eisenman. I've been working with IBM and iLog for quite a long time, usually on creating optimization solutions. So on the UI part, on the architecture part. And I've joined a few years ago DecisionMan, which is an IBM partner. And with IBM and DecisionMan, we have built a new version of a Decision Optimization Center, which I will be presenting today. The goal of this tool is to help you in creating and deploying application that will be available to the end users, so to business users. That's really what we want to achieve. We want to make sure that the optimization model that you have built becomes visible and accessible to the business user that will actually use its value in an efficient way. So to achieve this, we are basically including different layers of products. So if we start with the product that you probably know the best, CPEX Studio. So this is the environment and the optimization model that can be used to develop an engine model. This is state-of-the-art server. This is a modeling environment. This is also accessible through Watson Studio. But the point here is that you have a great way and a great tool to build optimization model. Now, the question that comes very quickly is, well, how do I access to a powerful resource to run my optimization model? Can I have a way to provide this optimization model as a service for external user, external applications? How can I deploy this application and this model? And this is where you have a multiple solution, but one of the solutions is what we call DOC Optimization Server. This is a tool that we presented yesterday. The idea here is to provide services that will allow you to run your optimization model on the cloud. And the point is that you will integrate your optimization engine inside what we call a worker. This worker will then be running on dedicated resources on the cloud. And then the optimization server master will be used to communicate and ask for execution of optimization models. This is, again, a nice step forward compared to the original CPEX libraries. But still, there is a need for additional things, and typically user interface to provide some feedback to business users, way to play with different strategies, way to manage different scenarios, and way to interact with the result. And this is, again, something that you will want to have if you want to push your model to real users. So this is the part that is answered by this DOC, Decision Optimization Center product that I will be showing you today. And the idea that connecting to your optimization engine, which is inside a service, which is itself available through this optimization server, you can set up or generate a whole application that will take care of all the features that you want for a business user or for a production application. So there is a web user interface, and the architecture allows to deploy on the cloud very simply. This is microservices architecture with Docker container. There is a scenario management included. There is a place for authentication and authorization. So we are talking now about a whole application. If you look at it from an optimization developer, this is an opportunity to move from a prototype that you have built and that you are very happy with into something that becomes visible and usable across your company or across your targeted users. And so what we want to do here with this tool is to help you to do this quickly. And you can see this as a two-step process. And the very first step is about getting quick visibility and access to users. So in this context, you would want to have a basic user interface. You don't want to have to develop things. You want to have some scenario management, and you want to be able to deploy that people can access the application. Then a second step can be to, of course, increase the capability of what you have done. And this is where typically you might want to do a more customization on the UI part, You want to integrate with external sources, and of course, you want to manage users in a proper way. So the idea of this DOC platform is that you will be able to get the first step in a very short time frame and without having to rely on sophisticated skills. We are talking about really a configuration here, no development, and getting an encapsulated optimization model into an application within a matter of days. And so we're talking about 1 week, 2 weeks maximum here. Of course, if you go to the production level, then you will be looking at something more sophisticated. And this will require skills, but those skills are very standard and very easy to find on the market. We are talking about web front-end development skills, back-end skills, nothing fancy and nothing proprietary here. So if we look at what's inside a generated application for DOC, you will get a set of services. Those services are represented on the right. So going from the top to the bottom, you have an authentication services, which will allow you to integrate with your Active Directory, making sure that the user has the right access and the right roles for your application. You will have a web frontend, which is the user interface that you will provide to the business users. You have an execution layer that lets you run tasks. And so we will see later that those tasks can be, of course, run on the optimization server, as we talked about before, but they can also be run outside. And then we have a scenario service and data service, which are in charge of managing multiple scenarios and configuration. The structure and the architecture of this application is based on, of course, Docker, as I said before. So this is a microservices application that is generated for you. The Docker, the different services are encapsulated as Docker containers. And those Docker containers can then be deployed using standard tools on Kubernetes, on OpenShift, on anything that makes sense on the cloud for your deployment. If you look at it from the point of view I described before, if you want to do a quick deployment with using standard feature of the application, you will not have to do any customization. You will just have to generate, encapsulate your engine, and then you'll be ready to deploy. As soon as you want to do a little more sophisticated application, then you go into using some extension points, which are represented in pink here on this slide. So you have a possible capability to configure the user interface. You have the capability to add some integration functions in the execution layer. And of course, you can configure the way the user have access to the different part of your application. From an integration point of view, and the application which is generated, if it's generated for a quick deployment, would be typically connecting through Excel spreadsheet or data files. But as soon as you want to go into something more sophisticated, we are ready to integrate with the Active Directory of your targeted platform. You will be, of course, able to integrate to staging or external system for input and output, and typically staging database. And as I said before, even though the natural way to execute our optimization engine is inside the optimization server, and there is a capability here to connect to the REST API provided by the Watson Machine Learning servers to an engine that has been deployed in WML. When you generate an application with DOC, you generate a set of projects, a set of environment and configuration files that allows you to work in a comfortable way across the whole cycle, life cycle of your application. So from the design phase to the development of the optimization model, the configuration or customization of the user interface, integration parts, and at any time you're able to assembly all your components, deploy them on a cloud or on a local server to make them accessible to the end user so that you can get the right feedback and loop again. This is part of the of the philosophy that was associated with DOC in a previous version. And we have kept this, and we have, I would say, emphasized this even more on the deployment side. Deployment has never been easier than it is today. I will go through a demonstration, but quickly highlighting some of the main features you get. You get feature for decision support, building decision support systems. So we're talking about visualization. We're talking about having control on who has access to what part of my application in terms of data, but also in terms of dashboard and views. We have the capability to work with multiple scenarios, and we have the capability to do some editing on the solution to try different strategies and compare the results. All these features are accessible through a web user interface, which comes with a lot of predefined components that you can use just through a drag and drop. But you have also the capability here to include additional components coming from the open source community or coming from your own libraries. The system is open here and allows to really build very sophisticated and interactive user interfaces. So time for a demo. So let me switch different screen. So the screen you see here is an application that has been built with Decision Optimization Center. So we are looking at a typical organization on the screen. When I log into the application, so let me log again. When I log into the application, I will be arriving on the home screen, which lists the different scenarios I will be working with. I have here two scenarios that are already predefined, but I may, of course, have additional ones coming from colleagues or that could be automatically generated through some batch scripts. I can create my own scenario by just importing some data. And then once I have selected a given scenario, I have access to a set of views, which are in fact organized as dashboards. And so we will see that we can build interactively those dashboards. You don't need to develop anything here if you're ready to use the standard widget we provide. Quickly, just to give you an idea of what we have here, the application itself is about capacity planning. So we are looking at a very simple problem where we want to perform some activities which require a certain duration of time. And those activities to be required, we need some resources. So we have a set of resources. Those resources have a limited capacity, limited number of people you can use at the same time. There are some constraints on the precedency. So you have some activities that must be performed before some other activities to be satisfactory. And all this overall is used to compute a plan, which we want to be, of course, as small as possible. With the idea that the produce schedule will be following the constraint we have on capacities, and of course we will make sure that the precedences of activities are satisfied. When you build those dashboards, and again I will show it in a few seconds, you can configure them interactively. You don't need to have a sophisticated knowledge on UI. You just need to know about your application, meaning that you have a capability to build this kind of application in a really a matter of a few hours. And you can also imagine that you can sit side by side with your business user and discuss capabilities or additional feature just by drag and dropping things and reorganizing sprints. At any time, I can use the application to run some functions. Part of the feature that are provided in a generated application is a place to do some data checking, and also, of course, multiple ways to run multiple optimizations. And so just by clicking on a button here, I will be able to start and the computation of an optimization model. And this computation will be running on the optimization server, which might be on the cloud. And then when we get feedback from the execution, we'll of course be able to see the results. So this principle is used across all the DOC application. You build your dashboards, you organize the different tasks that you want to be able to run from your dashboards, and then you configure the dashboard to run those tasks. So let's see how to create a dashboard. So I will here add a new dashboard. I will call it, I don't know, IBM Web. I will select it, it's empty by default. And let's assume I'm close to my user and he wants to, he asks me to be able to do some what if on the capacities of resources. So he'd like to play with the resource capacities to see what the impact. So the first thing I will do, I will add a widget inside my dashboard. This widget, I will want to let me access the resource capacity. So let's call it headcount. I'm picking here one of the information that I have stored and defined for my application. So this is really, I'm talking about the data I'm using here. I'll pick the resource capacity and I'm saving this widget. I can now resize this widget to leave some space for other information. And this is the part that will allow me to change the capacity. Now, what I'd like to see is once I've changed this capacity, I'd like to be able to run my optimization model. So I will add a new button. And this button, I will link it with some of the tasks I've defined. So I will give it a name. And I will look for the different tasks that have been associated to my application. And one of them is the engine execution. I'll just save it. And now if I just click here, this will start my optimization. So you see that in a few seconds, I have already something that's reactive. Now, of course, I'd like to see the impact of my changes. So I will add the KPI widget here to show the overall time span of my schedule. So I will get this information from a table that I've prepared for this. I will show the time span. So now I see that for my current solution, I have a time span of 68 days. Maybe I will add some Gantt chart for better understanding of my solution. So again, I will pick from my data model the part that I want to represent in my Gantt chart. So the different activities, I want to show this organized by resource. The application will then show me the Gantt chart. And now, so I have some dashboard. Of course, we could make it a little nicer, organizing things better, but I already have a dashboard that makes sense. And what I can do now is say, well, let's try to change some of the capacity we have. So if we go here, you will see that M1 is pretty busy. I might want to show this in a better way. So we'll use another additional visualization. We'll show a chart, which is resource usage. I will get the information from a table of my data model. I will want to show information day by day. And then the part that I want to see is how many number of hours I'm using a resource by resource, using the name of the resource. I want to stack the values. And now I have something that allows me to understand my solution. So let me reorganize a little the screen that we can see things better. And I can validate now. So I can see now my headcount. I can run my model, I can see a KPI, I can see the whole solution, and I have a visualization on how the different resources are used. You can see that M1 in gray here is represented in gray here, so I have a very quick way to recognize what is represented where. And I can say, well, let's imagine I have less M1 people available. So I will just edit the value here, Sorry, double click here if I can. And let's say I have only 10 people available. I will validate my change. I will run my new schedule. And so once the schedule has been executed, I will be able to see the impact of the changes. Of course, I would be able to compare multiple scenarios here and check the impact of my different choices. So now we have the result coming. You can see now we have 133 days instead of 68. You can see that the whole plan has been spread across a much larger horizon. So this was just to give you an insight on what can be done with DOC. This is a very powerful platform. And it's really meant to be used for two kinds of usage. The case where you want to quickly accelerate the usage or the adoption of your optimization model, so get a fast application available for business users to play with in a production environment. And then, of course, you want to move from this stage into a more industrialized application. And this is also where this platform excels. It can be your application that you generate can be deployed absolutely anywhere. So we are running on Docker, meaning you can run during your development on your laptop and then later push it to a private, a public, or hybrid cloud. So quick summary here. This is a platform that should help you to build, deploy, and run optimization solutions. There is the idea that things are simple. If you want to do a simple application, you have a great way to do it. And of course, if you want to do more complex and more sophisticated application, we are also here to support you. When you get DOC, you have access to Cplex, of course. You have access to the DOC optimization server, which is one of the ways to run the optimization model on the cloud. And you have also access to all the capability I showed, like the web front end, scenario management, user access, and so on. This is the end of my presentation. You have here my contact. You're absolutely welcome to contact me if you want to have more details or more information. And we'll be sharing with, I think, when we close this webinar, IBM will share with you some links that you might find useful to get more information and more materials on this product.
Okay, many thanks, Michel, for the nice presentation. And you are even ahead of time. And we got a question for you that came on the chat, on the Q&A, sorry. And maybe I can try to open the line. Please remember, you can raise your hand now. We will start the live session. We will be answering questions on the Q&A mainly. And I can also unmute you, especially if you raise your hand. You remember the small icon on the right side of the screen. Then I can see your hand raised and I can unmute you. Okay, so we got a question, Michel. Can the application also be used as data entry? I'm allocating the question to you. Can the application also be used as data entry from the user, or is there a separate view for data input definition?
No, so the user interface allows you to do absolutely any kind of interaction. So you can absolutely use the user interface to input data. I would say that if you are planning to do a lot of data input, you might want to consider either to customize some widgets to help you doing this in a very comfortable way, or rely on dedicated tools to do the input. But it is technically not a problem to create a whole data set manually here. What we also offer is integration with Excel, meaning that you can also rely on Excel to input the largest part of your data and then potentially just use the user interface for small changes.
Okay, thank you, Michel. So, Noemi, I unmuted you. If you are satisfied with the answer, or if you have any additional
No,
options.
Thank you. The answer was pretty satisfying.
Okay, perfect. Thanks. I see Wolfgang hand raised. I'm unmuting you for a question. Hi, Wolfgang.
Hi, Sophia. Thanks, Michelle, for the great presentation. Just a question regarding the migration work we have to do with the application we built with the old DOC and the new ones. Do you have any recommendation regarding best practices regarding this kind of migration work we have? So what are your experience of this, and what are the best practices you already identified?
Yeah, so yeah, that's a very good, very interesting point. The DOC 3.9 and DOC 4.0, as you understand, is very different beast. We are looking at different technology. So we there are some parts that where we are definitely helping you. So typically, the data model that is used behind the scene to store your data and also to handle it through in DOC 3.9 is something that we can import. So we can import the schema that we have used in the previous version of your application so that you can find exactly the same context in DOC 4.0. The migration of the optimization models and optimization tasks, and I would say generally speaking, everything that's about data processing should be fairly simple. Of course, it depends on what you have done exactly, but we are providing, at least at the Java API level, very similar APIs at what was available in 3.9. There is a part which is a little more work, which is the user interface, because as you see, we are not talking about the same technology. And so if you have done very custom user interface using maybe JViews, as was possible before, then it would be really probably as meaningful to spend some time reviewing how to translate this into the web. I would say overall, my advice from my experience would be to spend some time with some experts at either at Decentraland or IBM that knows both of the tools, and so that they can guide you and tell you what are the potential issues and what are the ways to go. We have some experience already with some customers, and we are more than happy to share it with you.
Okay, so don't
see this as a short project. It is it is some work.
Yeah, of course, I assume a lot of work which has to be considered in the first steps, how to do this kind of migration for larger applications. And of course, I assume that everything what has to be done with the UI has to be built up from scratch. And so I understood you provide this, nearly the same kind of APIs to integrate the widgets we provided for DOC applications in the new technology. And as I understood, there is a way to, let's say, migrate the backend assets from DOC 3.9 to 4.
Yeah, that's correct.
Okay, fine. Thank you very much.
Welcome.
Thanks, Wolfgang. So I'm unmuting Segev now, who has a question for you, Michel. Segev?
Hi, Michel. Yes, can you hear me?
Yeah, hi, Segev.
Okay, hi. Thanks for the great presentation. So I have a question. What's the development process in the new DOC? In the old one, there was this integrated development environment in Eclipse, and you also had the process where first you defined your data model, then based on that you could already generate the visualizations, and then tie in the optimization model based on that. So could you say more about what the development process in the new DOC is like?
Yeah, that's a good point. So it's very similar. So we are still starting from an optimization. From a business data model. So just like you in Trina, you used to use Eclipse to do this description, describe the schema of your data. Here you use a different tool, but you will describe your data model. And then we use this data model to generate all the different parts of your project. And again, this is very similar to Trina. The difference then becomes in the fact that we have, I would say, separated the different parts of the application in a smaller services with the idea of being a microservices based. But the structure of the development is the same. You first describe your data model, you generate an application, and then you start working in parallel on the optimization model, on the user interface configuration, and on the integration. And those three parts can be done in parallel. At any time, you can, of course, merge the work to deploy and show things to your customers. And you can loop. So once you have, if some feedback or some on the user interface or even on the engine that requires you to add something in the data model, of course, you will be able to update this without regenerating the application.
Okay, thanks. So could you say more about which tooling is actually used to create each of these parts, you know, the code development, the data models, and so on?
Yeah, I can. So I will answer shortly, but if you want, we can spend a little more time to go into details. So we have a textual tool that allows you to describe your data model. At this stage, this is entered manually. So if you have an existing application, DOC39, you can generate this from your previous model. Otherwise, you just write the description of your different tables and different entities and how they relate to each other. And then once you have done this, we provide a generator of application, which is part of the DOC framework. And this will create a set of projects that you can then configure and build. Those projects are organized in a way that helps you to know where to do what. And those can be directly used as a developer inside typically any kind of IDE. We are using IntelliJ Community Edition, which is a free IDE, and that I would advise you to go for if you don't have another one.
Okay, thank you.
And one last thing, part of what we generate is the different part of your application, but also the configuration you need to deploy your application. So your application, once you have generated, you can compile it and run it locally or on the cloud in a matter of literally minutes. It's really very, very comfortable.
Okay. And Michel, we had another question for you that I got privately. I need to define the front-end web interface specifically to each use, to this use?
Yeah, the web front-end that I showed before, it comes with a default, a certain number of default components. It's available immediately when you start your application. And what you have to do as a developer or as a user of the application is to create the dashboard. So I've shown you how to create dashboards. And this is typically what you will be doing. You can create dashboard just for your own usage, or you can create dashboard as a user that will be then available to other users through the application. So you don't have to develop the web user interface. If you are happy with the widget we provide, you just have to do a configuration like drag and drop.
Okay, and Aviad, I will try to unmute you if you are okay, because you had also other questions mentioning you have an enterprise customer, you want to deploy dedicated front end, and you know, what are the requirements for that? So I'm trying to unmute you, Aviad?
Yes, well, this is the first time that I've seen the DOC, so I have to do some thinking before, you know, I go into details, so I think I should contact Michelle later on, okay, on these issues. I feel more comfortable on that.
Okay, perfect. Let's do that. Okay, thanks, Aviad. Michel, another question for you. Do I need to have knowledge on front-end development, like Angular and TypeScript, to build an application?
Yeah, so that I think that's a very important point. You have to understand, if you look at the screen here, you have really two different steps here in the deployment of an application. You can have the quick step, which is the first one I have listed here. In this context, you don't have to have any knowledge on Angular, on front-end development. You will be doing what I've been doing during the demo, which is drag and dropping and configuring dashboards. This is quite acceptable for a simple application and simple UI, and already brings a lot of value. Now, to be honest, if you want to do one step forward, have something very interactive with a lot of capability on the UI, there is a chance that you will need to do some customization. And when I say customization, I mean development. And so it's a very good idea to have, as a part of a team in this context, a front-end developer. But I would say it's really the difference between using the capability out of the box, which is the first case where you will not need any knowledge compared to going further, and where you will need probably knowledge on the UI, but probably also on integration and probably also on deployment.
Okay, thanks, Michel. Another one we got, is it simple to deploy a DOC application on a public cloud?
Yeah, very simple. So I was planning to show it to you, but I had some troubles just before, so I didn't do it. But what we provide here is a set of configuration files that are ready to use, that can be applied on any Kubernetes or OpenShift instance you have booked on the cloud. So the first step is to book a Kubernetes cluster or an OpenShift cluster on the cloud using Microsoft Azure, Google, IBM, whatever cloud provider you want to use. And then the next step is just to run our scripts. And then in a matter of really minutes, you get the whole thing running on the cloud. There is a part which is about booking the machine and the cluster on the cloud, but then deploying on the cluster is very simple.
Okay, thank you. And another one, is it possible to encapsulate an existing engine into a DOC application? And not sure about the existing engine, should be an engine built with CPlex or not? Is it possible to encapsulate an existing engine into a DOC application? What is the amount of work required?
Yeah, so this is a slide I'm showing here. Your engine, you can run it in multiple places with a DOC application. The natural way to run it is inside the optimization server component, which is part of DOC. In this case, you have to encapsulate your engine into what we call a worker, which is one of this yellow bubble you see on the bottom right of the screen. The work you have to do here is about transforming the data we provide to you in a specific format into something that can be understood by your engine. So it's a matter of reconnecting the dots between data that is stored into the scenarios to your engine. You can also call explicitly external services to run your engine, and a very good possible candidate is a WML server engine. In this context, then you will have to prepare the data inside the execution layer you see here, and then send the data using the REST API that are provided by WML to your engine. So in both cases, the work is about preparing the data in a proper way and retrieving the result of your engine. So it's some work. We are working right now to make it as simple as possible. So there is some work to include a Python engine and making it possible to receive directly in your Python data in a format that is compatible with data frames. So we are working on making this as easy as possible. But today there is a little work to do here, and that's the only work you have to do, in fact.